to my channel. And today, we are going to read Top Secret. First, at the end, like, subscribe, as always, and write a comment to my videos, if you can. Okay, but first, I got this from Thrift Books yesterday. I read up to chapter 8, but we're going to just read chapter 1 today, okay? So, Top Secret. By John Reynolds Gardiner. Miss Green. It was the day we had to tell Miss Green what our science projects were going to be. I was excited because I had thought of something really neat. You see, Miss Green made a big deal out of the science projects. At the end of the year, there was science fair and science schools from all over the country were represented. There were awards and prizes and a silver trophy for the best project. There was also an award for the best science teacher, an award Miss Green had never won, but she wanted to. That's why your science project was more important than your homework or even your test scores. Last year, Miss Green has actually flunked 2 kids because their projects weren't good enough. Come to order, came the sound of Miss Green's deep voice, and there was an instant quiet in the room. Miss Green stood facing the class, her hands on her hips, her mouth curved downward into a frown. She was a big woman with a large head and a large lower lip that curled like a bulldog. Let's start with you, Peggy. Miss Green had written each student's name on the blackboard in alphabetical order. Start with Peggy Applegate. I was next. At farm, said Peggy, who was sitting right in front of me. Stand up when you address me. Peggy shot to her feet, her piggy tail swaying. I'm sorry, I forgot. She took a deep breath. I want to do an ant farm for my science project. If that's all right. Miss Green grumbled. In my 20 years of teaching, there has never been a year without an ant farm. Why should this year be any different? As she walked to the blackboard, the tractor tread, soles of her shoes made squishy sounds of the slick linoleum floor. What are all the thinkers of tomorrow? The scientists, the engineers? They had to be kids once, didn't they? She picked up a stick of chalk with her thick fingers. How I have longed to find a student in my class with an original idea. Someone who showed real imagination. Just one. That isn't too much to ask, is it? Miss Green wrote the words and form onto the blackboard in large capital letters next to Piggy's name. Ellen Brewster, came the sound of my name, a voice that sounded more like a bark than speech. My heart began to pound against my chest as I stood up. I noticed everyone in the class was looking at me. I couldn't wait to tell Miss Green about my project. She had said that she wanted something original. Well, she was gonna get it. I have an idea, I said, that was gonna win the silver trophy. Everyone in my class started laughing. Peggy Applegate twisted around in her seat and was grinning at me with a mouthful of braces. Barry Kramer, who sits right behind me, is the toughest kid in the fourth grade, started kicking my chair. Even Miss Green looked as if she if she were about to laugh. "The silver trophy," she said. "Now really, Ellen, you know as well as I do as the silver trophy is usually won by the senior in high school. No one in grammar school has ever won it. A kid in the 10th grade won it in it 1 year." "Yes," agreed Miss Green. "But Ellen, he was a genius." "So maybe I am too," he said. I said. Ellen laughed again. "Believe me, Ellen, Miss Green, I can think of nothing I would like better than to have you win the silver trophy. But we must be realistic. 1, 2, and being 2 are two different things. Don't you want to even know what my idea is?" "Of course," replied Miss Green, looking at my head at the clock in the back of the room. "But don't take too much time. You still have to hear from everyone else." I was sure as soon as Miss Green heard what I wanted to do, she would change her mind. "I was going to do a project on human photosynthesis," I told her. Miss Green said nothing. She just looked at me. "I got the idea last night at dinner," I explained. "My mom fixes liver every Thursday. I can't stand liver." And then it was just sort of hit me. Plants don't have to eat, right? So why do humans? Why can't we get our food directly to the sun the way plants do? Are you saying sunlight would be our food? Yes, and then maybe and a little water. That this is your brilliant idea, the one that spirit, I'm sure of it. And you know what, Ms. Green? You probably win best science teacher because my idea is so good. Miss Green seemed totally lost for words. She rubbed her face with both her hands for a long time. When she finally looked at me, her eyes were red. "This is beyond a doubt the most ridiculous idea for a science project I ever heard in my entire life." "Why, you said you wanted something original." "First of all," said Miss Green, "the mystery of plant photosynthesis, the process by which plants convert sunlight to food, has only recently been discovered and still not fully understood in every detail. That's why I want to do it. And secondly, to adapt photosynthesis to humans is impossible." "Why? It just is. "But why? There must be a reason. You just don't know what it is." Miss Green's eyes narrowed into razor blades. "There's only one thing I do know, Ellen Brewster, you were told to have an idea for a project by today. You obviously didn't do your assignment." "That's not true. So let me tell you what I'm going to do. Since you can think of anything, I'm going to give a project for you." She walked to the blackboard, picked up the chalk and wrote one word to the right of my name: lipstick. "You will do your project on lipstick, Ellen," Miss Green said. "And if it's not the best project on lipstick I've ever seen, I'll flunk you so fast your head will spin." "But what about human photosynthesis?" "Assuming it were possible, it would take a genius. And believe me, Ellen Brewster, genius you are not." So that's the end of chapter 1. Please like this video, subscribe, and like, and also write a comment below if you can. So bye, everyone. I hope you have a nice time. I hope you have a nice day. Bye, everyone.